Like it's the dead one,
dating,
isn't it? Isn't
you know, them all dating website videos.
Like,
hi, I'm Nomad Clan and I've got a good sense of humour. I like cats.
We're Nomad Clan from Manchester. We paint giant murals internationally and locally and whatever else we can do. We create things. I had a bit of a pop-up shop a long time ago that was called Nomad, and for whatever reason it always resonated, and I think at that time it was because I wanted to be traveling as much as possible painting. When we started working together, it felt natural to have a name that really kind of emulated like our life. We noticed that pretty rapidly. We were always on some crap bus or, you know, whatever, going somewhere and sleeping on people's floors to paint walls. The name was already kind of semi-relevant then, but it's just now it's like, oh, okay. So it all makes sense now, you know?
But when we first started painting together, because we kept meeting at various like events, because there wasn't many females painting in the north, we kind of gravitated towards each other, didn't we? And we did that for about 4 or 5 years, bumping into each other. And then I got commissioned to paint a big wall in Manchester and was like, I need to pull someone in on this. It was for the gay village. I wanted to bring in as many LGBTQ people as possible. And Joy was like the first one that popped into my head. I was like, yeah, she's a massive gay, I'll get her on board. And then the rest is history, really. It just went on from there.
That was the start of us taking things quite seriously, because we'd been quite overlooked.
And before Nomad Clan, actually, we had a crew. It was 5 of us, and we were called TNT, which is short for tits and tampons. I sat in the pub one day, it was like, right, we need a more hireable name if we want to take this seriously. So
it was an all-girl crew, and it was built from people across the north, so mainly Manchester and Leeds and Huddersfield and whatnot. But like the other girls were all, they were more into graph. They were very graph and pretty hardcore at times about it. And we were always the ones who were like, you know, doing weird characters and bizarre stuff. And it was really odd concepts for walls, but it was all like very much like graffiti production jam stuff, wasn't it, that we were doing? Yeah. Then we found that, you know, people were more and more interested in the, you know, the characters. And I guess like I was always from slightly like arty, weird, musicy background thing. And that was something that I've always been practicing, you know, like characters, and whether it before I picked up a can or what. And Hayley at the time was like, you would more letter forms, characters. It was very, very different to where we are now, yeah, stylistically. But it's been interesting to see how working together has kind of really started going more and more into like realism. And I guess our influences have become a lot more diverse as well.
That's fair.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
Joy beat me into submission. I had to paint like that. I'm only joking. No, I used to do more like really clean lines and like you said, like letters and bold illustrations and stuff like that, and a lot of black and white work. But I was getting, I won't say bored, but kind of frustrated with the limitations to that, like, because I used to sketch more realism, but I never painted in it because I didn't know I could, you know. But when I started painting with Joy and like learning from her and how to, you know, like create nice blends and taking those like really linear kind of straight letters or, you know, shapes and bringing them to life by putting your techy
weirdness
bits on top. So then it just kind of evolved from there. I mean, at first it was a bit of a mishmash. And like we did a solo exhibition and called it the mashup because it was literally like you could totally see two styles coming together. But like over the years, like there's still elements of the straight clean lines, like the letters that we've done on this piece here. Sometimes we do put like graphic kind of elements into stuff, don't we?
It creeps in. And it was quite like a liberating process, sort of switching over. Suddenly, like, you know, there'd be these really crisp, clean things, and then I'd just go like make a mess all around it or whatever. Kind of just explored. I think we've really just explored.
Like you could see two influences rather than two different divided styles.
Yeah, I think we've got a groove of working now, so it's become a lot more professional. Business? Not professional. It's become our livelihood, so we're taking it more seriously.
The whole heritage thing came from a place of we're getting invited to these places to come and paint, and when we finish painting, we leave, and like we leave a piece of like our artwork there. A look into the history and the heritage. Like, I mean, so many people have come up to us at this wall and said, I didn't know that happened, you know, I didn't know that story happened. And then there's a conversation there. And I think by doing the heritage things, we've found a way of tapping into different areas. No matter where we are, we've always got something to research and, you know, like a story or a folklore to get our teeth into.
We like to celebrate places that are often forgotten or, you know, off the grid. But this place is full of history. Like, you'd need weeks and weeks to even get anywhere close to hearing half of the stories, you know. I'd like to think that people can feel like proud or inspired or connected to their like heritage and their, you know, their community. The beauty about public art in general is that it's there and it's accessible for anybody. Not everyone's going to go into an art gallery because it can be quite intimidating or people don't feel they have a place with that. Whereas with street art and public art, it is there exactly for the people that are around. So we actually became more important to us than at some point along the way than anything else.
It brings a community together, and because they've got nothing else but each other. So like it brings these people together. So you can't solely put that down on the street art, but it's the people there having the foresight to say, we need to do something else. We need to bring like something positive to this, shine a positive light on it, because up until now it's just been like bash, 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 bash. It's using art as a tool to like totally change the narrative of a place, which is brilliant, I think. We're really torn with the whole street art and brand relationship. And I think sometimes that can be seen as, you know, a negative thing, because basically it's exploiting street art and turning it into something that people cash in on who have nothing to do with the scene. You know, they've not interjected anything to that. When brands get in touches, we try and work with them in a way that they work with us as artists. They get a piece of art, they don't commission us to paint them an advert. We've only really had negative experiences with
corporate
brands, so we do try and stay away as much as possible. Do never in my wildest dreams did I expect it to be this fucking cool. Like, you guys really need to realize like what a big thing this is. We've been chatting to people down at the wall and they're saying, you know, these guys, they're going to be, their names are going to be on the map. Like, that's from little old dears with their wheelie trolleys and like kids, you know, like everybody has such positive things to say about what you guys are doing. That's because, you know, you really are doing something.
Yeah. This was once a really, really, really successful seaside town, which I, like, you wouldn't really know apart from the fact that you're kind of bringing that back.
We both come from towns with a similar story, like they were once booming for whatever it was, but you've just got to have that idea and, you know, someone pushing it, and that's what you guys are doing. Like,
yeah, it's refreshing to meet like-minded individuals who are doing something, you know, that, not saying it's selfless, but what I am saying is, you know, it's predominantly about improving an area. And I think that, I'm not saying that's rare, but it kind of is a little bit.
I'm well excited to see where this is going. Well excited, we're definitely back. Mm. You won't be able to get rid of us. We'll be squatting in that flat up there.
So we've got a lot of work to do this year. We've got loads of big projects. The first half of the year, we're actually kind of being more based back in the north, back at home. But for the last 3 years, we've done a lot of traveling and a lot of painting. And that's absolutely wonderful and like an absolute luxury. But it also, time passes very quickly and then you suddenly come back to reality and back to earth and you're like, oh, what's happening? Like, you know, we're back home. Trying to spend the first half of the year doing some of that. So we've got some massive projects that we've been working towards for a while with some great organisations.
So that's kind of the plan for this year. We'll see how that goes, because we can't say no to anything.
Mm.
Short answer is no, I've never been arrested. There's been a couple of close calls, but to be honest, I was never really into illegal stuff. Like, I've never painted a train, I've never really broken into anywhere apart from old derelict mills and things. I mean, I enjoyed the whole process of painting, so I liked to spend my time there, so I didn't want to be having to leg it or, you know. We were quite fortunate in Manchester because there's a good few legal walls, so you could just rock up and paint, but like, I think my favourite places to paint were, and still are, like little abandoned spots, and we've got pieces hidden around like Yorkshire that no one will ever see them because they're just that tucked. We go for a walk and we find this old derelict building. And
I think for me it was always about just seeing what I could get out of hands. You know, like just getting as good as I could, as you know, and really immerse myself in it. So the idea of having to be on edge, but like the whole time for me wasn't always great. One occasion a cop came up and had seen us painting in Croydon and was like, "You got permission to do this?" And we were like, "It's a community project."
And then he just
and he was like, "Great, you know." But it's because it's like, you know, it was figurative and it, like pictorial, and you know, I think if it, you know, if we were doing letters, then it's a very different
attitude. It'd be nice just to be remembered, wouldn't it? That's enough for me.
I'd like people to think, okay, they did this for, you know, they did this for themselves. Like, self-made. I'd like to take this as far as we can possibly go. As long as we're inspiring people and making a difference, and that I'm content enough with that, to be honest. As long as I'm happy and love what I'm doing and I can see positive things coming from it, then I'm on the right track. If that turns into something else, then yeah, maybe it's plan B, I don't know what.
I would collaborate with Dali. With you? No, with Dali, I think, for the crazy surrealism. Kandinsky for the weird colours, and Madsy for the fact that she's just a genius.
This is a really difficult question, because I actually get a bit sweaty about it, which is weird. But Frida Kahlo, absolutely. Good. Yeah, she's, yeah. Gustav Dore.
Was a better than mine.
No. Just because dark, twisted, what the hell was going on with that guy's brain, you know, 1800s, I don't know. It's like, really? And then who else? If we're talking street art and stuff, I'd like to collaborate with London Police, just because they're good eggs, and they're totally different style to us. Or Etam Crew, who were massively influential to us as well. Or even, I mean, Faith 47, that'd be
pretty
good.
Anyone.
We're always down for collaborations, just saying.
Stay off Instagram. And just do it, you know, like, you can fall at the first hurdle when you look at other people's work and you think, oh my God, they're getting every wall that they go for, or, you know, they're getting every job that they go for, and it's not the case. Like, everybody, you know, buffs that Instagram post up till it's squeaky clean and sparkling. Like, you don't have to be brilliant when you start. It's about putting the time in, and as long as you're doing something you love, you'll always find the time to do it. And like, we spent a long time not getting anywhere with this, you know, like, but at the same time, we're always working on ourselves. And I mean, we used to say to each other, like, something's gotta give, this has gotta like work somehow. But I think if you really want it, you just have to keep going, and eventually, you know, you reap the benefits of that. And it's far better than, you know, sitting at a desk and working for somebody else.
I do believe that the more passionate and the more love you have for what you do, so find your thing. It might not be spray paint, it might be something else entirely. But like, I'd say just make sure that you've got that connection and that it makes you happy. Do it like a motherfucker, basically. Yeah. And it's like a dirty obsession, really, by the end of it. And there's so much history here, there's so many stories, and there's great like resources to learn. Found one that was about smugglers. People used to kind of hoodwink ships by lighting fires or whatever.
I guess our mural is kind of a homage to that whole time. The guys with the barrels was the story of the ship that got shipwrecked. The town went down there and took all the rum and just had a massive party. I absolutely love that. Like, even our experience to this day, like painting here and like having fun and getting drunk is basically what we've done while we've been here. I think it kind of fits nicely.
Oh yeah, and the message, the text element as well, because that was taken directly as a saying, I think, that used to be said around here. Every element that's in there is meant to mirror something to do with this story. On a slightly deeper level, we're kind of looking at the idea of past and like the narrative of what that means, and you know, what's built a place, and you know, how actually, so in some respects, that sort of almost like pirate mentality, or that like, you know, like determination to break the rules and do whatever you want. In history, there's so much of this stuff, and we kind of get a bit nerdy about it, don't we? We like to know where we're going, and we like to know, you know, what it's about. And you guys should maybe make films about what happened here, you know?